Is that India? What happened to her hair?
Well, if I wanna shave it close, so I wanna rock locks that'll take a bit away from the soul that I got.
Hello, ladies. It's Martika, and welcome back to my channel, Beyond the Beauty. And I just wanted to speak with you today on a subject that I've been having with a few ladies that has taken interest in some of the wigs that I've been wearing. They are not wig wearers, and there's a lot of people out there that aren't, but basically has taken some interest into it because it has become so popular again, just about as popular it was back in the 70s. The comments that I've been hearing is, they look so good on you and they look so good on other people, and I don't know if I can do it because I don't want everybody knowing that I'm wearing a wig. Come on. First of all, if I know you and I know that the day before your hair was probably right here, or your ponytail might have been this long, you know, and you come in with a wig the next day that's this short, or if your hair was like this and you put on a wig that's this long and ongoing, everybody's gonna know it's a wig. Hello. Everybody's gonna know it's a wig. The key is to make it look good, to the point to where those who do not know you may have to second guess and ask, is that a wig? I wonder if it's a wig. Whatever it is, if it is, if it isn't, it looks doggone good. So that is the key, to make it look good. Make it you. Make it yours. If you have to get it cut, colored, whatever you have to do to personalize it to yourself and to your own personality, just do that. Forget about what people have to say. So many people live their lives based on what other people think, what other people have to say about them, what they have on, what kind of makeup they're wearing, what their hair look like. Usually, the people who's talking are the people who want to try these things themselves. And personally, my motto is this: if you have enough time to critique me, you don't have enough to do. Simple as that. You don't have enough to do if your time is spent talking about what you feel is wrong with everybody else. So my advice to you ladies, if you want to try it, try it. You only live this life one time. You don't get a second chance. And the only person you need to worry about pleasing is yourself, your spouse, and God above. That is all that matters. Now, the issue that me and my spouse have, he likes long hair. He's not crazy about wigs and this and that. But guess what? I like it. Not saying that I don't care about his opinion. Yes, I do wear my own hair sometimes. But at the same time, yes, I do like to clip on my hair. So keeping it covered is the way to go. So when he sees me put on these wigs and these different styles and things, and I make them look different, he doesn't mind, simply because it looks good. And he hears the compliments that I get from other ladies. And so that's pretty much all that matters. If it makes you happy, if it looks good, go with it. Forget about what other people have to say, because people are going to always talk. They're going to talk if you wear a wig. They're going to talk if you don't wear a wig. So who cares? Live your life to the fullest. Do what you enjoy. I do. I guarantee you I do, and everybody who knows me personally will tell you that. The key is make it look good and have a good attitude about it, because your attitude can change anything. You can be the most beautiful, photogenic person in the world, but if you have a jacked up attitude, you can hang all that beauty up, because if nobody wants to be around you, who cares? So make sure your attitude is in check. Make sure that you're a likable person. Make sure that people love you. Don't be self-conscious about what you're doing, what you have on. Because when you blot other people out of your mind and you're happy with what you're doing, if it looks good to you, that's what matters. So I just wanted to come to you with that tutorial today. And if you're wondering, yeah, I still got on the mommy wig. But I must say, I probably confused the people I work with this week, because I've been about three different people. I did the mommy wig Monday and Tuesday. I did Tammy Wednesday. I did Yasmin yesterday, which was Thursday. And I'm back on the mommy wig today simply because I didn't feel like doing the slicking back and all of that. And this is just a fun piece. As you can see, I have it styled a little different. And I tell you, I am loving this wig. So I'm doing me. I am long one day, short the next. Might be midway tomorrow, but who cares? I like it, and it looked good. So you all have a good day, and I'll talk to you again. God bless.
What happened to her hair?
Well, if I want to shave it close, so I want to rock locks that'll take a bit away from the soul that I got. Little girl with the pressing curl. Age 8, I got a Jerry curl. 13, and I got a relaxer. I was a source of so much laughter. 15, when it all broke off. 18, and I went all natural. February 2002, I went on and did what I had to do. Because it was time to change my life, to become the woman that I am inside. 97 dreadlocks all gone. I looked in the mirror for the first time and saw that hey, I am not my head. I am not this skin. I am not your expectations. No, no. Hey, I am not my head. I am not this skin. I am the soul that lives within.
Why she do to her hair?
I don't know. That
crazy. I like it.
I wouldn't go that far.
Good hair means curls and waves. No. Bad hair means you look like a slave.
No.
At the turn of the century, it's time for us to redefine who we be.
Shave it off like a South African beauty. Got it on lock like Bahamali. You can rock it straight like Oprah Winfrey.
If it's not what's on your head, it's what's underneath. And say, hey,
I am not my head.
I am not this skin.
Your expectations, no.
Hey,
I am not my hair.
I am not this skin.
I am the soul that lives within.
Does the way I wear my hair make me a better person? Does the way I wear my hair make me a better friend? Oh. Does the way I wear my hair determine my integrity? I am expressing my breast cancer and chemotherapy took away her crown and glory. She promised that if she was to survive, she would enjoy every day of her life. Oh. On national television, her diamond eyes are sparkling. Bald headed like a full moon shining, singing out to the whole wide world like, hey,
hey, hey, hey, hey. I am not my head.
I am not my head. I am not this skin.
I am not your expectations, no.
If I wanna wear it braided all down my back, I don't see nothing wrong with it.